aso ejo nyankopon ni anadwo yin so se okunim bia ko a ono urade ono so agi na fi esum kabi bi mu no odeno ebeye achede emaye anadwo yi.
Let us please the Almighty God that one seven of his which he salvaged from very thick darkness will be a blessing unto us tonight.
Se eyo de se urade bedum yensa dia
if you are pleased,
let's clap unto Jesus.
Now let us give a clap offering to the glory of the Lord.
Clap unto Jesus
Christ.
Let us
big amen to that.
Arousing
amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I do your son, Yamiani, where you tell me to say, Yamia, almost one time very hardened criminal onwa beka nasem enyobia seya yemia owu and abi say oye osempakeni from prison to the palace of Christ.
Amen.
Osempakeni Awudu Raman.
We're calling upon the evangelist Awudu Raman to come and share a testimony with us.
Bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
And now Nadji. Eyeme nijie, eyeme ahuwa huwa se nyamia faso kupeniso Pastor P.B. Kranche eni asafu mani na mesosua kamensa menfatasei wama ya kwenye bietisei.
It is a great joy and honor tonight that the Lord has called his saints with our head Pastor P.B. Kranche, and he has called me in addition to be a part of his saints.
Eni asofu mufria mwanoni baye ina sosono mede asida sumukone demao.
And I'm grateful to the Lord for even the pastors who are present in our midst. My prayer is that the Lord will grant us his spirit. There is something brief I want to say before I delve into the testimony. Whenever I see the head pastor, Pastor P.B. Kranche, I often look at him very well. Do you know why I look at him very well? Because he has decided to stand for the truth. When I came and I was sitting behind him, I kept looking at him. And during the time of worship, all I saw is that he knelt down and lifted up both hands. And with what he did, I could tell that he was receiving something. And so when he came to Sanye and began to talk, he talked about the fact that the Lord revealed that there was a cage, an ancient cage, and with an ancient padlock on it, but then the Lord sent an angel to break that padlock so that those within will be set free.
And
initially, I was thinking, I was wondering what he was going to say when he said that the angel broke the padlock. And he made us understand that certain people were in that cage and they were set free. As Christians as we are, many of us might be Christians, but if care is not taken, the enemy can cage us in such a manner. Before I became a Christian, I often had a dream that I was in a very deep
pitch,
a very deep hole.
Oh.
A very deep pit. At that time I was a Muslim, but until I became a Christian, I couldn't come out of that pit.
nyamia fa sofo so hu se mena bi awudama deka bi awudama no awurade yi wafrim.
Amen. And the Lord through our pastor tonight has made us understand that any cage where you find yourself or any pit you find yourself in, the Lord has set us free.
Me di the evangelist Awudu Raman me nimse enche bia me di ne be evangelist Paul become be se me Raman free ho ne Awudu free ho.
Amen. I am evangelist Awudu Raman and I know in no time my name will change to evangelist Paul because I want to take away the Muslim name.
Me papa ye mala wo ye mosini awo makaranta wo tichi alif ba wo tao me ma mi se do goment ye wo me to Islamic religion mo ye fani fani bia.
My father is a malam who teaches at a mosque. He teaches how to pray and then read the Quran. And my mother as well is also a Muslim, so I was born into Islam.
When my dad
and my mom divorced, I was in class one, and since then I haven't gone to school again. So as I stand here, I dropped out of school in first grade, class one.
Na ya jin kwa Yesu Kristo ofa omo ko school adura chiri no aba fo mo Yesu so ya nko school no a enka bibia sa no na odi aka ho no ma ya juma ba ko se enye.
So our Lord Jesus Christ, he uses those who have been well educated and then comes down onto our level and uses us all together to do his work.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
At the age of 11 years 13 14, no na minim cigarette nom na minim ensanom na minim winom na minim sleeping tablets nom ne extra any mafo keka ho bebrebe.
During my early teenage, I had gone into smoking of cigarettes, smoking of weed, and using of so many substances which I abused them.
Na me kaise na minim nana akokora na da edan ba akum na edan na edam no edan single room no na edan no one side say no na enkoko da ho ana minim nana so da one side say we hear nipa wo ne nkoko da dan ba akum.
I remember I was sharing a room with my grandfather and in that room there were also some fowls sharing the room with us.
Na minim se urade be mi say
I didn't know the Lord was going to bring me this far.
Minim ba bia wa share si efre.
I don't know where he said it
from. Me pesa udu jidi ewe urade Yesu Kristo mu.
But I want you to have faith in the Lord Jesus.
Won show education background.
He doesn't consider
won show
from he doesn't consider how beautiful you are. Your height, the Lord is not limited by your complexion. But if only you give your height, then where he is going to take you, where he is taking you, no one has even stepped foot there. Are you used to sleep with fowls in one room? The Lord has given me the opportunity to stand here on this holy ground. Who has done it? It is the doing of the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Give a clap of offering to the Lord. I started taking in cocaine in addition to the substances that I was taking.
Na me kasa anima we na bomo na me na the street of Alaba na me ko osu am santin kromo ho na ona me to cocaine. Me na me first person me to cocaine ho. Se me hu se car ba na me se meti machika na chimbotom.
And I used to trade in cocaine over there in the street of Alaba. I was the first person who began trading in that, and whenever I saw a car coming, as a result of that which I was taking, I felt like I could crumple the car and then keep it in my pocket.
Senipa Osaka ba ne oso beti machika na chobotoma sena bo hunu nipa.
If you are a human being and you see a car in such a manner, then how much more your fellow human being.
Tina mi hunu nipa mbo.
So I had no mercy for any man.
Anantiti de mame as a Islam no me pe Christo ni bi asem.
And the upbringing that I had in Islam made me hate every Christian.
Because ya mame hu se Bible na kura ya na
and I was made to understand whilst I was a Muslim that the Bible that the Christians use are not complete. So I always saw every Christian as an unbeliever. Let us put that aside and then let us come to my life as a thief.
Me bokro no nketenkete fifie.
I started to pilfer from the house.
Epia bonti.
And then I took it out.
Finally me be graduate e be arm robber.
And I graduated gradually into being an armed robber.
Manya robber bia keke o.
It wasn't any ordinary armed robber.
Me ganka me no mo nam no.
But the gang that I was moving with,
me patona me gang leader.
I was the gang leader.
Enne me de urade ase.
But I give thanks to the Lord.
Sa mama me leadership wa.
That he has given me a new leadership.
Mama no Christ mu.
That is in Christ Jesus.
Na baby na mi jana mi jani pano window echi se ya pe na ni pano ma light off one dem hunti no mi mi jala light mu abunti wonu ohu mi mi hu no ana obo mi to far window no cross range na mi ben pa.
I was one day going to rob someone and was standing at the window of this person and the light inside the room were off, so I couldn't see the person, but that which was outside was on, so the person saw me and shot me from a close range.
Abuba no fa ma chi pe abuba na nka me na me free o ka che me na mo fo no se senka ma anya smarta ka papa no bo metu oku me obie no we smart ni tuo before tuo be chi se tuo di pe na abuba na kan da na urade mpe se me wu me boni mu no oje me.
But the man missed the target, the bullet couldn't get to me, and I said to my friends that if I weren't smart the bullet could have hit me. But one thing that we need to know is that no one is smarter than a bullet. It takes only the grace of God. If the Lord hadn't saved me, I would have been dead and gone by now.
Ana sa okokumasa ta fo fo ma sa. Ye wodunsini bi wo ha sa ye kwaye robe na abuba etuo ka emu bia. Ye ntimi mfa nko hospital. Ne akọ no ho na ye heba doctor obe charge ye ni wajiska ni wo yi abuba na maye.
And there was a fetish priest at Tafofo Mass that whenever we went for any operation, any armed robbery, and we are hit by any bullet and anything of that sort, we came to him often so that he will be able to work on us and charge us once again so that we'll be on our feet to go and work again.
Hallelujah. 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 Na papa no kwanye wo fa so edi abuba na me bihe kire wi woni mse ye kono ho a wode nanu na ye operation nanu odi to abuba fi ni paduam.
I want to demonstrate how this man took away the bullet from our bodies. He did it with his mouth.
Se wo koduru wa na wode nanu asi ba bia etu abuba na ka no etu abuba ka obi a tete nam no ese pia enam ni bi kowuram. It was an usua, no a chi and mojefino and nam no grenu yegu from or betcha was so betcha born to no yatu from near Chiana Kaneko.
One thing is that when a bullet hits someone, it tears up the flesh and then pushes the flesh backward. So whenever we got there, what the man did was that he would put his mouth over there and then draw out that filthy blood and then draw out the bullet from the body.
Now, Chi Madame Fubi Abuba man or catch them as an Adam from Madame from Nenamo and you know.
So when he was pulling out this bullet from one of my friends, he told me that the flesh of that friend is very bitter.
Papa no wau.
And that man is dead now.
My brother, a drone baby adokowati.
There is nothing we can rely on aside God.
Ana migusu ameya robbery.
So I was still into armed robbery. I thought I couldn't be arrested. Very strong. And very well armed as well. And I had so many chants, so many evil powers to protect myself. But the Bible says that sin will kill the sin will kill the sinner.
And finally,
into the real here, no. I was arrested. And I was beaten. Blood was oozing out of my body. And I was arrested at Asawase. And no one is ever arrested there for that person to survive.
I feel more free taxi so on Ramme fire, taxi drop and so on fire.
And when a taxi was called to come and take us to the station, he said he wouldn't because our blood was staying in his seat. So what they did was that they washed us with water so that all the blood would be drained out before we were able to sit in the taxi. We were brought to the police station. My brother and my friend and I were cuffed on the hand and on the legs. The next day my head was swollen.
Mark Mohammed more than 1 inch.
And there was a mark here that my head could go deeply through. All that they had wanted to do is that since we didn't die at the scene, they wanted to leave us there so that we would just die and they would bury us. They didn't take us to any hospital.
Even paracetamol,
no medicine, not even paracetamol was
but before 3 weeks time.
Now, so answer Abusumi and Awachimi and said, Bruno. All the sores on my body were healed. There are certain people who have been injured and for a long period they have not been healed from that injury. So am I also part of those who are loved by the Almighty God? My friend was left to go scot-free. And I was charged with another case. And when my friend went, he went to rob again. And he was shot by a police. And what he said was that. He said, it is finished.
It is finished.
Sasa.
He is dead.
He was called Yabema, but he's late now.
Tribunal Court within the Revolution era.
We were taken to the tribunal court.
Na emra ebe di a case na mi case mate bakupeja anensa.
And when the case was presented, someone lifted up his hand.
Mi a mi case mate too.
My case mate.
Asamo okanye ne se chairman. Papa ojina hoyi. Say me na me nya papa na me young man, 20 something years. O se abranta ojina ho woni na ye gang leader. Se wu jae na oba ko form new gang. Am robber o prosecute ni am robber.
And he lifted up his hand, my case mate lifted up his hand and said to the judge that this man, this young man you see here is the gang leader, so if you let him go scot-free, he's going to go out and gather another gang of thieves, so do not let him go. Do you know why he said this? He was part of my voice. And looking at the kind of lifestyle he was putting on, I dismissed him from the gang.
It's
Robbie
a
good boy? So he wanted to pay me back for that thing which I did.
So when the prosecutor said, "Who has been
When the tribunal judge was passing the judgment and then he called the prosecutor if he had anything to say.
You know what the prosecutor said?
You know what the prosecutor said?
Was he? I did first accuse no were prosecute case na yenti me ni bibia ka biem.
And he said that my charge mate or my comrade has said everything, so he has nothing to say again.
And to me, I that Roman and my sister, but I'm going to sister, said the Aquasi, because I have death sentence. Because PNDC law 78, so we are robbing our punishment here, death sentence.
So that day, my sister said that looking at how this person is speaking, you are going to be charged with a death sentence according to the PNDC law.
And to Yankan and Luntum.
So we should shut the person up.
And to Korea do sneeze your babble.
So they decided to go and seek a fetish priest who would be able to help me. And he went to a malam. And the malam was he required for the tongue of a baby who died right at delivery. And I asked my sister, where would we get some? And she suggested that we go to the mortuary. We went there and we got some. And we did the ritual. But it couldn't shut the accuser up. He kept speaking. Whilst I was in remand, they were bringing me certain charms to use on my body that I wouldn't be sentenced to death.
Finally, tribunal chairman was sentenced to death. And shooting by a foreign squad by AK-47.
And finally, that was my sentence to be sent to the firing squad to be shot by
AK-47.
And in the laws of Ghana, when someone is charged, sentenced to death, that person doesn't put on any clothing or anything, but then the only thing the person has to cover himself is the blanket.
And Central Prison.
So I was in Central Prison.
And
over here, they do not kill those who have been sentenced to death, so I had to be taken to Accra.
na lega eguye nsa ne nan bet sa lega yo na eguye nan ne nsa no se emu boto no se me fa mu boto ba ho ma pita na ne pam anu no se mi ya metim de bi lega ne han kop ntima pa ho ma ne bi e de asia bet me bi lega ne han kop na kamadwane.
And whilst we were being conveyed from Kumasi to Accra, we were bound by a certain leather cups on our legs, and with that with a little thread from the sack of a rice, I could have untied that leather, so I had that on me so that as we were going, I would be able to set myself free. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When I realized I was in Sawon prison,
Operation Commander Odeko do in Sawon Oka Chem said, Baba Idi, ye bechi wano waira, what di nuro, ya chi woka pa ye ma, aha, diye mi nipene waha, what is he enku ebe jao no wasei.
And the commander over there told me that they had severally tried to arrest me, but I always disappeared because of the charms I had. But now they have arrested me, and over there are two things involved. Either I'm left to die on my own, or I am sent to the firing squad. That was the account of man. That was what a man was saying to me, but the Lord hadn't spoken yet. Amen. I want you to understand that as you have come here, as you live here as someone who will be living the holy life that you want to live in Christ Jesus, just deafen your ears to all that men are saying to you.
Papa,
when I began to preach the gospel, I wasn't well educated. And I decided to preach in English.
Word of God, no matter the word of God. Hey, word no word, no, the word na begina word na na.
So instead of saying word of God, I used to say world of God.
I don't know
what you are saying, that people are making a mockery of you as a result of your educational background. Do not worry, the Lord is going to use that to prepare you.
Anaja, ya match me dey mewura condemn cells.
And I was marched into the condemned cell.
Emra me wura condemn cells. Na mia the same prisoners omo omunye condemned prisoners no mo bobo. Do omo kan say the jeria na ntwe ni biba. And ntwe do matter sad e nche me kunkum omo.
And whilst I was going, there were certain prisoners who were in the condemned cells who were playing football outside where I was, and all that they said was that the fat cows of the then president Jerry had been brought, and then in no time they are going to be slaughtered.
Emra mi wura condemned cells, 5 iron doors and they dey make to up land inside wall. Chance e dey mam say me ni dim na e kuraba, plastic color, green color, and kura pipe am ya pimpam kuraba.
And when I was taken to the cells, there were 5 iron doors gates that were preventing me from going outside, and I was kept in the top corner. And over there, that bowl which I was given to feed in was a chamber pot which was even damaged and had been staged with a rope.
Say me ye rob ya na me na Meridian Hotel, Kennel Light, She Club ana me ji mani no. Say me wie ye eye kuraba mu na medidi.
Not knowing that when I was doing armed robbery, going through so many expensive hotels and so many nightclubs and enjoying myself, I didn't know that I was going to end up feeding in a chamber pot. Whatever gets given to you, not by Jesus but by Satan, you need to flee from it.
John 10:10, John 10:10,
the Bible says that the thief comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. When he was coming to kill me, he made me feed in a chamber pot.
Me da condemn says ono na me ye landan landan ye kramo kukoni me na me fresh sala na manfo be sala me sue Quran wie o condemn a me set be ye imam me di domo ni no me sala.
When I was in the condemned cells, I was like their muezzin. I used to call for them to pray, and I used to lead the gang over there, and to I was like an imam over there in the condemned cell.
Because Bibia concerning Islam, as a imam qualified as a imam, no, ni na masuya.
Because everything pertaining to Islam that needs one to be that one needs to know to qualify as an imam, I knew it all.
Na adia ba akone se somebody ka catcho se ne ya condemn Bible, mama se Bible ni correct. Etimi da condemn says ona mi ponwi yo.
And I've already told you that for us Muslims, we are condemned the Bible. That Bible wasn't good and it wasn't complete. So whilst in the condemned cells, I used to sell weed over there.
Na me sell cigarette oh.
I used to sell cigarette as well.
Sleeping tablets oh.
And then sleeping a tablet.
Na unim paper crata me dey turn we oh.
And do you know the paper with which I sold?
Let me use the Holy Bible.
I was using the Holy Scripture.
Me tete a chene e dey to kunia.
I tore out the hard cover.
Na me dey apostles so.
And with the scissors,
let me cut the pieces.
I started to cut out the papers to be used.
Let me see me to
regular to smoke weed and sell
them.
But blessed be the name of the Lord. That Bible which I spoke, I am not able to read without this Bible. And that which is within me is coming out to the glory of the name of the Lord. Clap to the glory of the Lord.
May the Bible told me about 16 years.
For about 16 years, I was selling weed with the Bible.
How many Bibles am I teaching?
You can ask yourself, how many Bibles have I
taught?
Now, if I'm today holding the Bible, testifying about the Lord Jesus, not knowing that life is within this Bible.
1993, one Friday night.
One Friday night in 1993, I was in the condemned cell and the operation officers came in.
Operation officers,
they always came to take people to be killed.
And
they came with sheets of paper with the signing of the death warrant of certain people all the way from Accra.
That month, almost 20 death sentence.
That month, 20 people's death sentence was signed.
Now, any affinity you do one wine,
and that is what we call we're taking them out one by one.
Why are some would you think I have to condemn on that Friday night? Now, they better me down upon now. Can you be
so? If your name has been signed on that sheet that Friday night, by Saturday morning, you wouldn't be part of the living.
And your mother condemns us on
so when they came into the condemned cell. We all have a radio that we used to listen to, and all I heard was that doom radio. No?
And the whole year, this cemetery.
And the entire place was quiet like a cemetery.
Not much I see a body, no.
And they began mentioning the names.
Condemn me, Abro sign.
The condemned was a story building.
And Tiabo Bidia.
So whenever your name is mentioned,
yes, all planning sad wall.
We mention where the person is.
Niakofano.
And the person will be taken.
Niakofano.
We mention where the person
is.
And there are certain people when their names were mentioned, they were asleep. Then we'll just wake him up that your name has been mentioned. You are not waking him up to sleep,
no?
But you are waking him up to go and die.
And
when someone is being taken away, he will say that they are taking me away, so when my family comes, please inform them. And someone would also say that we are going, and if Christ permits, we shall meet again.
And
at that time, I had been in a condemned cell. I was left with two shorts and then one Muslim garment and then one yellow shirt. And so one friend of mine who was going to be killed told me to take his bucket and his clothes and then manage with those. Whilst they were being taken away, they were worshipping God. They were worshipping God. And they were being taken away. And it was only one person who was taken out because he was blind.
19 people do omo kon na ebi e innocent.
Some of those 19 people were innocent.
Omo e cha samo to om so.
Some were falsely accused.
They know them and him be say friend Mustafa Bruce.
And one person who was close to me was called Mustafa Bruce.
Ebi e o ka chere me say were innocent.
He often told me that he was innocent.
Na me nyini.
I didn't believe it.
But san adun e dey no kon.
But that night when he was taken.
Na the case mate ka say
and his case mate confessed that indeed he is innocent.
It's too late.
But it was too late. He was taken to the firing squad to be killed. How much more I used to sell weed with the Bible and didn't believe in Christ.
ana awurade kire me end time said the wey ase beko na wey yesterday.
I was there and the Lord revealed the end time to me.
Asase wey na na ne eje firi ba bia firi su ba bia eba.
And then the entire earth was melting away and fire was coming from all angles.
Mi hunu prelu.
I saw it twice.
Mi hu ba ku bia de cha na ma fon ya kristi se obi ma yare bo sume ba ko.
Whenever I saw it I trembled and then became so sick.
En so man sa chira ma dwene.
But I didn't repent.
Yeda condemn wa na aban ma mne se say ye twa 10 years and over na every condemn ra life in prison.
And once we were condemned, the government came with an amnesty that all those who have been condemned for over 10 years now should be brought to life in prison.
And tim na me fi condemn see life in prison am say what? Life in prison as a chance say me ne aban be ku ashe obi am fa tuo mo me. And be edi tuo bo me kura me nsacha ha na me sachira.
I was brought from being in a condemned cell to a life imprisonment, meaning that I was going to live with the officers over there till my life is taken away naturally. So how much more now that I've been given a little liberty that I will repent?
Na the whole and sawam yard upa mo na upa wi ni wa nye bia unye bi ba bibia.
So in the whole yard, whenever anyone wanted my daughter and came to me and didn't get any, means that you wouldn't get any from elsewhere.
Edi e di frem ho ya baba idi.
And my name over there was Baba Dingi.
Woni ma de enter Baba Dingi dam record so.
Do you know why I was buried that name?
Emra ye chi mi no.
When I was apprehended,
ye busam so Dingi say,
I was asked for my name.
Ana mi si mi didi Baba Idi.
And I said my name is Baba Idi.
Mi mi di Abdulrahman mi de sie.
I was hiding my actual name.
Woni ma de enter.
Do you know why?
Se mi didi pia bon tina e be me na be 20 cases.
If I'm to mention my real name, I would be charged with so many cases. So I knew the kind of things that I did, therefore I changed my name.
And I'm in the yard.
And I was in the yard.
One year time.
And
one year time.
I was transferred to Ketekrachi prison.
Ketekrachi prison. I'm through here. I'm in a black coat. Black coat. You're a prisoner. Or two missing. You're a prisoner. Black coat. That's that class. Me na me a prisoner. E bia me me hun soroma. It is other prisoner be there 5 o'clock. Me me there 5:30.
And over there, I was given a prison called the black oath, meaning that I was the leader of all prisoners. So if other prisoners would sleep at 5, I would sleep at 8:30.
Me say be na kitchen leader. E say na block leader. Na me kura three posts.
I became the kitchen leader and then the
kitchen leader and the block leader.
Okay, so I was having three posts over there, three positions.
Adiabu some dem obi atoko ni wate.
Whatever Satan has given to you, let go of it.
Enti mi wo ho ana sofo ma me bi flin kran ba won so ya ex muslim.
So I was there and one pastor's wife came from Accra who was an ex muslim as well.
Madam Dockers, Mighty Stone.
Madam Dockers.
Na sama me no ba no, se o ma bom pa e won kran. One in the for me, and the radius of moment to the crash prison. Now, for people who are more Joseph in the family, and upon some do matter to make Kenya Miss Montana radiance here.
So, when that woman was coming, not knowing the Lord had revealed to them that there are certain Josephs in the family, there are certain people who have been in prison and they need to be preached to so that they'll be able to repent.
My many buyer on it, prisoner for Kenya Miss Mimi or Kitchen, I mean, what do you mean?
When the woman came and was sharing the gospel with the prisoners, I was in the kitchen. Getting food. I began to laugh, saying that Christians are stupid. They have no sense. Look at them allowing a woman to preach to them. And afterwards, she's even praying for
them.
And in Islam, that is not allowed. So I laughed seriously. And the woman said, "The Lord has sent us here. Many of you are Josephs over here. And the Lord wants to take you to your families." And I said, "Look at what she's saying."
As a prisoner,
all that I need is amnesty to go here. And what use is Joseph to me? So the woman left.
A week time.
And in a week time, I was going to the storekeeper to get food to be cooked for the prisoners. And the woman asked the prisoners to back with prayers. And I saw that a dove was flying and then hit the wall and then fell down. So I hastily picked it up.
Sabo ana minya che metimi di abola I soup in prison.
I knew I could have prepared a soup with it in prison. When I talk about prison to you, it's like hell on earth. If I want to talk about condemned cells alone, we wouldn't leave here
in time. Because condemned sinner, Obi who I wanted them to fool better condemn her. Any point to me, that or 3 days, none is sent at you now.
I've skipped so many things.
As soon as you told
I didn't talk about so many things because even in a condemned cell, we used to sleep with dead bodies for about 3 days, and the stench was so powerful that we used to feed over there. That is why I do not want to spend much time over there for the sake of our time. When I picked up the bird, I had within me that I shouldn't kill it. It seemed weak, but not dead. And I thought within me that I could have prepared soup with it, but I had this feeling within me that I should let go of this bird. And one of my friends realized that I didn't want to kill the bird. So he had wanted to spank the bird so that the bird would die immediately. When he threw his hand, I took his hand away. So he couldn't hit the bird. So I held the bird at the bird where, and then the bird came back to life. So I went to one corner of the prison. And I said that, Lord, you have given me this animal. I could have used it to prepare soup.
But
I'm going to let it go. As the bird is going, let me also be liberated. And the bird was gone. And the prophecy was there. So I was there one night. I had smoked and I was lying there. I was lying there.
Prison officer search me one year because me to almost 17 years.
So no matter how well the prison officer would come and search, I've been there for about 17 years, so they wouldn't find anything on me. I had much experience. I slept and I was snoring heavily. And I had a dream. The Bible says that there are two ways before
us.
One is broad. And one is narrow. And the Lord, through our pastor, has blessed me today.
Because all come at 2:7, 13:14 going, and I say, yeah, this is the man can't tell the Lord Jesus. This is the dream I have.
And when he was talking about Matthew 7:13 and 14, when I make us a way that you saw and you come down and the chair, you
know,
that the road was very broad. And so many men were plying that road. Some were enjoying themselves. Some were also dancing worldly forms of dance. And there were young men with earrings on. At that time, I had an earring on. And men with sagging pants on the Broadway.
And it's like crazy jeans, you know.
And men wearing crazy jeans on the Broadway.
And the crazy jeans and naba.
The tattered jeans is very common. They wear it everywhere.
And I said the footballers, you are multi style.
And the styles of the footballers, the hairstyles of the footballers. I saw all of them on the Broadway. And I saw women as well. Women wearing provocative dresses, showing their boobs, their breasts.
And you did go.
Not that which is being exposed, but the bit that is being exposed. That small bit of the body that
is being,
I saw it on the Broadway. And I saw women wearing skimpy clothes with their tights showing. With their tights exposed on the Broadway. And I saw so many rituals, so many. And the voice told me that I would Raman. Have you seen all these people? All those blind people. They are in this world. That is not what you are supposed to do. You need to find a narrow way. Though it is narrow, it is a very narrow. It is very difficult to take that
route.
I heard pastor has already preached about that. You wouldn't want to take that narrow route. But that is the path of the Lord. And I was directed into the narrow path. I was looking at it quietly. That the narrow path is very quiet, but that the broad way is very noisy. Whilst walking on that narrow path, getting midway, I saw a man there. He turned his back towards me. And so he was standing with his back. And I asked, who is there hindering me from going forward? And he turned and looked at me. And when he turned, it's our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
40-something years.
I had been a Muslim for so many years.
About 40 something years. But that night, when
I saw Jesus, no one told me that was Jesus. I knew that he was Jesus. It was the Jesus that I defied and spoke against. He was the one I encountered.
Thank you. No, I can't even see so.
And he was seriously looking at
me.
He didn't smile towards
me.
He didn't like what I was doing.
Jesus
despises evil.
Though
he may listen to your voice as a sinner, he doesn't want to look at you at
all.
He has chosen evil. So I looked at him quietly. And I said, Jesus, I am a sinner. Forgive me my sins. I didn't say anything.
Yet.
Jesus knows your heart.
For three at once.
He smiled immediately. And he walked toward
me.
He embraced me.
Oh, Papa.
Oh, Jesus. So Jesus loves me too. Just place your hand on your heart. Place your right hand on your heart and close your eyes. Say something to the Lord.
Say focus on the frame of me this enter.
If indeed Jesus called
me
and has forgiven me my sins, then may he forgive you yours as well as Jesus.
May
he purge you with his blood. If you have anything to say to the Lord, this very moment say it to him. And he's going to forgive you.
Amen and amen.
Amen. In Jesus Christ's name. Believe that he has forgiven you.
And
by the time I realized I was in the prison, I was weeping. That Jesus loves me as well. I cannot smoke weed. I cannot smoke cigarettes. I couldn't fight anymore. I couldn't trade those drugs anymore.
And prison authority, 15-20 years ago sentence.
And I felt within me to send all those things to the prison authority. I was holding them within my hand.
And
I was taking them to the prison authority. And they asked me, where did I get these from? And I thought that I said to them that I thought I was a dead sheep. And so I was just living this kind of life over here. But this night, I have encountered the Lord Jesus. I cannot smoke my water anymore. I cannot sell it anymore. That is why I brought it to you.
Man, I show me say I was say my year 25 years. Me who be that say prisoner that we are bread prison officer.
And he looked at me quietly and he said, I have worked for 25 years. I haven't seen
such a thing
before. So we're going to Koforidua prison to go and preach. I met one officer that I sold my daughter to, and he turned around to testify about me to the prisoners. And they asked me to go, that they would call me when they
need.
So when I came in again, I heard within me that I'm a Muslim. I heard a voice. And now that you've met Jesus, you want to stop Islam? And I
called
I went to a friend of mine in prison called Kweku, and I told him that I had a dream and I met the Lord Jesus. Initially, I didn't like the Christians, but now I love them so much. And he also told me that he had a dream that I was also I repented from Islam to Christianity. And I came to him and I said, Jesus, if indeed you are calling me a Christian, then the task you've given to me, I wouldn't do it. Neither today nor tomorrow. You can take away my life. Whilst there that night, I had another
dream.
I was under a pit, a garbage. I was at a garbage dump. I was suffering.
Na ball and asking a hot time me who bit.
And looking at how filthy the place is, there was so much smoke over there. I wasn't
made the whole flat.
I wasn't sitting, but I was lying flat over there. Then the Lord Jesus came for the second time. And he said, I would get up. And I said, Jesus, I cannot get up. Then he held me a little
bit.
And he asked me to go with him. And when Jesus asked me to go, I saw the refuse as a very high story building. Like a new story.
Jesus saw me and said,
and Jesus held my hand and wanted to climb with me, climbing a ladder. And whilst I was climbing, we encountered very ugly things. We encountered filthy things. And the smoke was going. But Jesus didn't leave me. He took me over that place and took me to the peak and told me that Awudu Raman, you see where you are, and I've taken you to do my work, and you are refusing to do it. And I said, Jesus, when you come to the Quran,
Surah
to
Maryam,
one surah, the name of the surah is Maryam. It is about your mother. It is named after your mother.
Surah to Maryam 1919, Muhammad boy Yesu Abaswa.
Surah to Maryam 1919, Muhammad praises the Lord Jesus over there.
And I am Muslim for a Judy Saudi and Nabi Isa Muhammad Maryam.
And as Muslims, we believe that your name is Anabi Isa and your mother is Maryam.
Islam to Christianity.
And why are you telling me to leave Islam to Christianity? And he said to me that Awudu Raman, I am the truth, the way and the life. And no one comes to the Father except by me, Jesus Christ.
Jesus is the way.
Yes, Christian, you are crying up.
When we have a mistake.
Yes.
You
are on the right path. That is why you are here. And I said, Jesus, I am not a schoolmaster. How can I do your work? What am I going to preach?
Jesus said,
I have called you. Go and testify about me to them. Just as you are, I have called you.
Jesus said, I have called you.
Jesus didn't call me to just testify by
me.
I am well versed in the word of God. When I preach, you might think that I've been schooled. It is given from above.
Anything from above is above. John chapter 3.
When you read from John chapter 3.
Verse 31. And Nabi Yahya, he didn't join in the Bible. And Nabi Yahya in the Quran, only John.
John is called Anabi Ahia in the Quran. And he was testifying about Jesus.
Say, the one who comes from above is above all.
Jesus Christ is above all.
Jesus Christ
is above
all.
And he is taking me to and fro. That is when I began to believe in Jesus. So I say no to you. I wasn't at the refuse dump.
Let me name for two.
I wasn't working in the dust.
But let me tell you,
but I was under the refuse. And Jesus, whom I knew by my Quran to be a prophet, the Quran says he's a prophet. I didn't believe in him. And I didn't believe in the blood that he
shed.
That blood was bestowed upon me. And that blood got to me. Did The enemy had wanted to destroy and kill me. And the Lord took me out of that
place.
And that is when I believed in Jesus. And I gave my Quran out and told my friend that I'm no more a Muslim, I want to be a Christian. People began to flee from Islam into Christianity. And there was a great revival in the prison. The Christians were charged. And that is when we set a prayer tower.
Prison of San Awudu.
And the prison of San
Awudu. Bompaya na uradi enyao.
If you do not pray, we cannot let you go. So pray so that the Lord will set you free.
And my ex-president of Wokono.
And at the time that the ex-president was about leaving, that amnesty that you granted, I was part of the list. And you know my prayer. I said that, Lord, I do not know anything in the Bible.
Compare Nima from the Quran.
I often compare things with the Quran. And I used to talk about Jonah. He was sent to Nineveh and he said, Nineveh. He was disobedient. You cast him into the sea. And he was swallowed by the whale. And he was vomited out to Nineveh. So the prison has also swallowed
him.
And if you allow me to get out of prison, I'll testify about you. Prison yard couldn't withhold me. And I was sent out of prison.
Say from prison to house.
Say me free prison abe fie.
Me baye mabusu fie ina ye Muslim kwa babu station amete nzongo ho.
And when I came, my family, the entire of my family were Muslims.
Omu say me nyesala.
I was living with them, but I wasn't praying with them.
Omu call emergency meeting.
They called an emergency meeting in the family.
Unu ma dia ba ko before me ba na ye ma yi o. Emu nse ma wunti na ye ma yi.
Before I came, I was counted dead, so they had already mourned me.
Ente Muslim fa ye ma dua.
So they had already done my funeral rites and everything.
And
when I was coming, my mother was frightened. She was so much surprised because my little child who I left crawling, my daughter, had grown and was married and had a child. And the husband even used to insult her that she had no father.
And to what you have Nigeria,
so she came in so much fury from Nigeria to Ghana to come and ask the grandmother where the father is, if not she was going to commit suicide. So when she was coming from Nigeria, I had also been set free and I was coming. When I came, I saw my mother. I spoke to her. She didn't say anything, but she went and then called my daughter out.
The right time.
Amen. May the Lord cause you to have a helper in due time.
Ma, prison as a Muslim. But mahu say Jesus de nsa kame. Ana o ma me hunu kure no. Enti say me e Christo ni.
So when I came, I told my mom that I went to prison as a Muslim. All you are saying I know, but then Jesus has touched me, so I have come out as a Christian.
Okan Quran sura 3. Okan Quran sura 3 ayah 45 wa.
When you read from Quran sura 3 and the 45th
ayah 45.
Verse
45.
The 45th verse.
Yes. Jesus
was given a name over there.
Was it kalimatullah? Unse kalimata Arab la wobet my kalamatullah. But kalimatullah ni said weye yankupon asem. That means yes weye yankupon asem.
And the name is kalimatullah, which means that Jesus is the word of God.
And also man a second name ruhullah weye nyamihum.
And the other name also means that he is the spirit of God.
And also man Isa al-Masih, that's Jesus Christ.
And he has been given a name called Isa al-Masih, which is Jesus Christ. So if someone is the word of God, and again the spirit of God,
Jesus Christ,
and he is Christ, then why do you call him a mere prophet?
Muhammad is a servant.
And the Quran says that Jesus is the word of God, but Muhammad is just a servant.
And me choose Jesus.
So I have chosen Jesus.
Mabusia for say
And my mother disowned me from the family and said I shouldn't even come to a funeral when she passes away. So they put me through hell. When you convert into Christianity, you are rejected by your family. Your friends reject you. Everyone around you rejects you. So I used to maneuver my way, hide, and then go to church.
So
I went to church one day. I wasn't having any work doing. So after close of service, I went to an elder. And I said, "Elder, today I'm suffering. I'm in dire need of money. Even money to eat is a problem. Even at that time, money to even go to the place of comfort, I didn't have any. Will you be able to stand till the end in times of difficulties?" I said it and the elder just passed by. And he said, "Awudu, that's your problem." He didn't give me a dime. At that time, they had given an offering, about 6 to 5 billion. And I knew that my family had rejected me. And I came to the church, and the church also rejected me. So I decided that I wouldn't go to the church anymore. But I would go to the home and listen to the radio to serve Christ.
Because she had my same partner.
And that decision that I took, one day I was going out and I met my partner, which I used to fornicate with some years ago.
Satan minu through Bibia. What the holiness said, Satan towns through Bibia.
When you come to accept holiness, you become a great enemy of Satan.
After no banana me called that pussy 18 years of Messramino. No, no, she said, "Mammy, chop money."
And that woman who didn't visit me all those years in
prison
began to give me money to
me. And
by the time I realized I was into fornication again.
And my brother could say Judas.
So my life became like Judas.
My Yeswama.
I betrayed Jesus.
And damn me, boy, Jamai.
That very moment I
forgot.
Jesus made me see that there was 3 barrels of water. They had almost been filled to the brim. And I had eaten and I was washing my dirty hands in all those barrels of water. So I spoiled all those water. And I heard a voice saying unto me that,
How do Raman?
You have destroyed everything. You need to pour away that water and start from the scratch and begin to fill it again. And what is it that is leading you to damnation? Our pastor told us tonight, what is it that is leading us to damnation? At that point where my Christian life was, when I went into fornication, everything collapsed
again.
I had to start from the scratch. Be careful that you do not backslide. The Bible says, for the sake of my name, according to Matthew 10:20,
it
says that many of you will go into persecution. And even some to the point of death. But he who will be able to stand to the end will be saved. Are you going to be able to stand to the end? I backslided. Satan gave me a quotation.
Now,
what are you talking about?
Solomon,
even Solomon had so many and so many wives. If you are not careful, Satan will quote the Bible to you. I went to sleep in one
room.
I had no place to go. I was driven out of the house. And that girl who I was sleeping with, she was about dying. I couldn't do anything about it. She was immobile and she couldn't respond to my call. And I said, "Look at how backsliding has brought me this far."
Me page me ni shesro.
So I lifted up my eyes.
Kote sheba me tu manum. Eh, Luke chapter 15.
The Bible verse that came in mind is Luke chapter 15.
Verse 11 coming down.
Verse 11 following.
But who do serve the one? Me oba di serve ono. Oji na japa de kose ni miye no.
And the prodigal son, when he went to waste everything he was given by the father, he came and said that I've sinned against
any major.
And then my father. So I'll go back to my father. Even if he doesn't accept me. And ask me to his servants. It is better off than being here and starving. So when he had that genuine repentance. When he had that genuine repentance. He went back to the father. If you are a royal and you leave the feet of the Lord, you might end up feeding with pigs. And that
trouble,
and that person who was wearing the pigs as a representation of Satan, very wicked.
So
I lifted up my hand and said, Lord, I'm a prodigal son. I've destroyed all that you gave to me. And now this is why I am. If this girl doesn't come back to life, I'll go back to prison. Because I have a bad record. Lord, please save me from a prodigal son. And I mention the name of Jesus Christ. He doesn't listen to sinners. But if you cry unto him, repented heart, then he's going to listen to
you.
So she began to breathe again. And she asked me, where were you going to take me? Meaning she wasn't going to come back to life. That is when I had a dream and Jesus was standing at the tip of a pit.
At my second, my third encounter.
And that was my third encounter. And Jesus was working assiduously. And he was very. And the work that he was doing, no one could have done it. I haven't seen anyone do that kind of time. I asked myself, what kind of work is Jesus doing? He was very, very dirty because of the work he was doing. And Jesus stopped working. He looked unto me. And he said, Awudu, Raman. Have you seen so many pastors in this world? Many are not doing my work. Just a few of them are. And even the few are doing it lackadaisically. So I've taken my work and I've doing it on my so I'm revealing myself to certain people so that they will help do my work. So you go around the world and Jesus was revealing himself to so many people. He has also called you and then you don't want to do his work. So I was frightened. And he told me that there isn't time for me. He said, go out and then do my work.
It's a God of many chances.
He gave me a chance to go ahead and do his good work.
And
the next time I had a dream and the heavens were open in a dream. And a voice came from heaven and told me that I would, my Raman, go and then tell the people of the world that I'm coming soon. I'm coming to judge this world. And I, the Lord Almighty, I've lifted up one foot, and I'm left to step foot. When he has lifted up his foot, meaning he's coming
soon.
And he told me that even if the whole Israel should
be
here, why was he saying Israel? And I was running in a dream, saying to the world that repent, for Jesus is coming soon. He gave me four groups with which I shared the word of God with. And the first group were a group of politicians. I said to them that Jesus is coming soon. He's about
stopping footballers.
But they didn't mind me. And the next group were footballers. So and they have taken over this world and they are having negative effects on children.
Football belongs to Satan.
Soccer or football belongs to Satan. And many of the youth have been driven by
that.
There are so many people who have been going to church for so many years, but then they are not even able to mention the 12 disciples of God. But when you mention football,
from Africa
to Asia, they have the names of the footballers. This means that this thing has taken Jesus from the throne. During the World Cup tournament, so many churches canceled their playgrounds because of the soccer or the football. You have allowed Jesus to be. You need to be careful if your mind is filled. Even what they put on and how they appear tells us that they belong to Satan. And the third were a group of church members. They were going for a pool party.
Matthew 5:28.
He says, even if you look last week at a woman, you have already
fornicated.
So what manner of clothing do such youth put on going to the pool party? They didn't mind me. And I saw my church members and I told them what the Lord had said. And only 3% of them listened to me. Only 3% of them.
97%
of them. And 97% didn't listen. Have you seen what the Lord revealed?
But
glory be to the name of the Lord. Over here. Right here. During this conference. It was a conference like this that I came here. Many were talking about holiness, but I took it lightly. What I was preaching then, when I came here, I had a personal encounter with our Lord Jesus Christ. That is when I came to meet Abraham Yakubu and Pastor
Gideon.
That is when I got to know genuine Christianity. Because then I was praying though. The Lord ministered something to me. The Lord made me understand. That if you are a Christian, you shouldn't throw a litter around or throw such a of water around. You wouldn't throw cans around. You wouldn't dump anything around your neighborhood. Even as a good Christian, you wouldn't split out anyhow. That even as a Christian, you didn't involve yourself in exams malpractice. And I was made to understand that even if you are a Christian woman and your husband gives you 20 cities to prepare
food,
and you are able to manage with 15, you need to be faithful to your husband in your finances. Such things are very strong words. So when I came here, I knew that indeed you are genuine
words
of the Lord. I went to work at the bank. I was a security over there. First Allied Bank at Asafo. Someone from Condemned.
I'm robber. Work at bank.
No, working at a bank. I got to a point, I was keeping all the bank keys.
I'm the first person to open the bank.
I was always the first person to open the
bank.
And
the last person to close the bank.
And then people try to amend
bank. Zongo police station.
And I'll take the keys to Zongo police station.
Bank here, the police station. Now, me the mensa class one. Now, me the assign my signature.
And I'll go and append my signature for turning in the keys.
Say yes,
when Jesus comes into your life, he makes you a new creature.
No matter how
no matter how much you are falling away from him.
So sorry.
Do not remain there, but rise up and look unto Jesus and cry unto him. And he is faithful. He is just to save you. Looking at my educational background and the bald head.
Bald head. Thank you. And then marks in the
and the marks on my face. And there are some on my body as well. I know that.
Okay, first John 3.
When you read first John 3.
One day.
I know that one day.
Jesus Christ will come again.
Jesus will come again. And if he is to come again.
Send me a
how I will look like Jesus. If only I live a righteous life. Once in a prison, I was taught a song. If only I'm going to stop living a sinful life and then refrain from all manner of evil and live a righteous life, then I know that the Lord is going to pave the way for me. Do not allow anything to deceive you. The world is soon passing away.
1 John 2:15.
It says, if anyone loves the world, then he doesn't have the love of the Father. Let's run and save our souls. Because this isn't any good place for anyone to stay. Some time ago I was a child. Now I am grown. In no time I'll turn 50. I'm not going back
anywhere.
I keep moving forward. When I was reading the Quran some years ago, it made me understand.
Every soul shall test the death of Allah.
That every soul shall test the death of Allah. Meaning that we are all going to test
Ah, my brother,
if that is the case, then run for your salvation. Run for the salvation of your soul. In no time, the Lord Jesus will
appear.
When you read Hebrews 12:14.
Media holiness.
I wasn't frightened even more with the holiness. But he says we should follow peace with all men. It is very fearful. It's a very dangerous thing. Someone might even want to take away your life. And he says we should follow peace with them.
Quran Surah 9:29. Okay, the same thing. The chapters in the Quran are not just say Omun Taki Christopher. Omun Panya Bibi. But Uba Babu Mama 2:5 noa. 43 noa. What's he a mumpa my time for?
When you read from the Quran, everything there is fighting the Muslims against the Christians. But when you come to Matthew chapter 5, it says that we should love our enemies. And pray for them as well. And he says that we should live in peace with them. Tonight say to the Lord, may the Lord give you strength with which you will be able to stand. As he held the hand of Peter, he should hold your hand as well. In this sinful world, he should take you to the latter and glory. All that I'm saying is that
Muslim for
the Muslims
and a Christopher
and the Christians,
we
do not serve one God.
And the Bible,
we do not serve one God.
Allah, no Quran.
their law in the Quran is different. And our Lord God in the Bible is a different God. So their God is different. And ours is different. That is it.
Can you
be in your feet even as I'm going
to pray?
You're
not being on your feet for me, but for the Lord. Tonight,
she
going to give thanks to the Lord.
Oh, Tanasi.
Thank him from within the
heart.
For having opportunity us to come before him this evening.
So for
if the Lord has created for us and has brought us under his feet, in spite of all the difficulties,
let us thank him for
that. And he has begun such a program with us. Let us give thanks to the name of the Lord. And ask him to forgive you of all your iniquities, all your transgressions. And pray to the Lord. That Lord,
every Muslim be out in the
every Muslim that is going to be touched,
they
should direct him to the right church.
Churches.
So many people have gone into wrong churches.
Holiness,
they are not hearing about righteousness. They are not hearing about righteousness. Pray to the Lord.
Say holiness God be.
That this holiness call
will
be echoed upon all Muslims in other churches.
Holiness life.
That they will lead holy lives
to
the glory of the name of the Lord. Open your mouth and begin to pray to the Lord. If your name has been taken out, may he give you the grace
and
to that. And rewrite your name in the book of life. And give you the enduring spirit. In the name of our Lord Jesus
Christ.
Say unto the Lord, that burden with which you came, at the end of this conference, may he take them away. And when he takes them away, your life wouldn't remain the same.